Sports Source is brought to you by Franklin Motor Company. Visit them at franklinmotorstn.com to check out deals like the 2009 Cadillac Escalade Hybrid. Only 76,000 miles, fully loaded with leather, DVD, backup camera, OnStar communication, Bose stereo system, heating and cooling seats, you name it. These are hard to find. Franklin Motor Company, your ride is here. All right, welcome back to the second segment of Sports Source here at Wild Wing Cafe, brought to you by Franklin Motor Company, as we have CPA head coach Brett Armstrong. Now, something interesting here. I looked this up earlier today. 1999 was the last time that the average price of gas was under $1. Did you know that?
I did not.
That was the last. It was also the last time CPA had won a state championship. Albeit, you guys have been to the state tournament several times, and I believe you told me 9 times.
I think that's right. Yeah.
9 times. So that was also 1999 was also your first year at head coach of CPA.
Absolutely. Yes. Yes.
So you come in this year. What made this team so different, so special?
I think we knew from the very beginning that we were a really talented team, but we've had talented teams in the past. This was a real senior-heavy team. There are 14 seniors, and for us, that's probably the most we've ever had. And so sometimes that can go either way. You know, the seniors, some of them are looking ahead to college. They're kind of done with the high school thing. But this group of seniors was really connected, really tight group of guys, and I think for them, they were determined to go out on a positive note. You know, they lost in the state. We had eight of our starters played football, lost in the state championship game in football.
Yes.
Three of the seniors played basketball, lost in the state semifinals in basketball this year. Yeah. And so I think for a lot of them, they were determined to kind of get over that hump and finish their senior year off kind of on a really positive note.
Now, how tough was it to have that drought from 99 to 2013, especially when you guys weren't just losing in districts. You guys weren't losing in regionals. You guys were getting there. You were just, you know, just a game away, a goal away from winning again. How tough was that from 99 to 2013?
You know, I think soccer's a funny game, right? Because you can, even the state final this year with CAK, we score on the header off the cross. I thought we kind of controlled a good portion of the game.
Yes.
But they had a couple headers at the end that went just wide. One of those goes in, their keeper saves ours, and all of a sudden we're looking at ourselves going, God, we didn't get it done this year. But so on some level, I think we've recognized that over the years that we've had great groups of guys who, we lost to CAK 1 year in the state tournament in PKs, right? 0-0 a game. We lost to them the next year 1-0 on a breakaway goal near the end.
Yeah.
We beat them 1 year 1-0 in the state tournament. And so those games can just hinge on the smallest little detail. And so we've tried not to define success in terms of do we win the state championship or not, although that's always our goal. But our success comes from, you know, are the boys connected to each other? Are the boys playing out of the right motivations? Are the boys getting the best possible experience they can have? And when you measure things that way, it kind of takes on a little bit different light. So I don't know that we were ever frustrated that we weren't winning state. It was always something that we wanted to accomplish.
Yeah.
But that goal, the fact that we didn't those years, there's a moment of sadness at the end, but then usually we're all hugging and within a couple days talking about how special the year was.
So the measuring stick is, did the players get better? Did they enjoy their experience, basically?
Yeah, we have this motto that's been around since, came up with it in 99, says love God, love the brothers, and love the game. And that's kind of been our, that's been our measuring
stick. I like
that.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, yeah, do we play out of everything that we're gifted to do? Do we play unified, enjoying each other? And then do we love the game of soccer in terms of the way that we play the game and the opportunity we have to play it? So that's kind of been the way we've evaluated where we've been.
Okay, so now we're talking about this season, 2014. You guys win the district, beating Page, win the regionals, beating Page. So we go to sub-state, and we'll go ahead and take over from those highlights. Here, you guys are playing White House, and this goal was one of the best I'd seen all season.
Ah, yeah, that's Harrison. Outside of the left foot, right, upper 90. He hit a goal. Our very first tournament of the year, we were down at Notre Dame, and Harrison, we were down 2-0. And we pulled back to 2-2, and Harrison hit one from about 35 yards. Wasn't bouncing, wasn't with his left foot, wasn't on the outside of his left foot, but went past the keeper and won that game for us. And once that one went in, I think the boys, I mean, that was a spectacular strike. And so I think the boys were jazzed, and and ready to go. Yeah, and then here's Josh Pettichini getting down the line. I think he's looking for a cross to the
back
post.
I was about to ask you that. Was that on purpose?
He might say it was. I don't think so. But yeah, but he was doing, we work on that all the time. You know, we need to get wide and get the ball crossed, and he did what he's supposed to do, and sometimes they drift the right way. And then Grady with his flip throw into JR, and I don't know how he got this past the keeper. Kind of.
Well, that's the same right foot that's kicking 50-something yard field goals
yeah,
in football, right?
He can hit a soccer ball. So I think he actually megged the goalkeeper on that one. But poor keeper. I mean, that ball's flying at him 6 yards out.
Yeah, you saw that all season with him and
yes.
J.R. Osborne. I mean, I felt like every game I was at, Osborne was scoring. I mean,
yeah.
Something that we kind of joked about with the PA announcer, that every game I'm at, Osborne's scoring. It's
well,
crazy.
He's a special player. He tweaked his knee in one of our last preseason practices and missed the first half of the season. And we were struggling to score goals, a goal here, a goal there. We're in a lot of games 1-0, 2-1.
Yeah.
And then JR comes back and we start scoring 5 or 6 every time. And it's not JR scoring all the goals. It was just it kind of tilted things in our favor. So, yeah, he's a fun guy to coach.
So you all go to state. You're in Murfreesboro, taking on Murfreesboro Central. And I would take over from these highlights.
Yeah, Tyler Grassi, our left back. Tyler hardly ever saw the field last year. Really committed himself in the offseason. He played club soccer. One of our three guys who did it got down the line, drew the PK, and then Harrison steps up and just slotted it. But Tyler might be one of our MVPs this year. At left back, he was just spectacular this year. Won everything. Didn't make a mistake, I can remember. Yep, and Harrison off the corner, ball bounces around a little bit. Grady heads it in, comes right back to him, and he hammers it home. Grady was our striker last year. We moved him out to outside mid this year, so he had to give up a little bit of the glory and sacrifice a little bit for the team, and he's a great story because he was willing to do that all year long.
So right there, you guys are now one game away from playing in state, and what are your thoughts going into that?
Yeah. Overwhelming. We knew Murfreesboro Central had a good team. We weren't sure how good they were going to be. We'd been hearing about them all year. To get through that game, we'd heard their midfield was dominant, and I thought our guys controlled the midfield in that game. And so we felt really good going into the semifinals, knowing that if we just played soccer the way we play soccer, we'd be in good shape. And that's what the guys did. So
you go to the state semifinal playing against Madison here, and
right.
You guys had already just scored a goal, and then you get over.
Yep, Jake Brown steps up, wins the ball. He's our center back, got to the corner, crossed it. Bryce Perdue's there to volley it home. We had just switched. The wind was kind of going that way, and the field was a little bit slanted there. It was 1-0 right before half. I think that probably came with 2 or 3 minutes left in the half.
Yes.
And so we had just switched. We usually play 4-2-3-1 with only one guy up top. We'd just gone 4-4-2 because we felt like we needed to get a second goal in that first half.
Yeah.
And then Jake makes the big play, gets it crossed, and Price stepped right around. And
Price seemed very humble after that goal. I heard some of the players on the sideline saying, Price, you just scored a goal. It's okay. You can celebrate. And he was just very calm after scoring a goal that was huge and seemed like that could be the goal that sent you to the state finals.
Right, right. Price was one of those guys. He would come off the bench for us maybe 10 minutes a half. And it's remarkable how many games he would get the big goal. The game winner, scored in that Notre Dame game, scored at Marshall County, scored some really big goal, or Giles County, scored some really big goals for us. And that's probably the biggest one all year. At the time, we felt like we had the game under control, but then, you know, it swings with the PK in the second half, and we were hanging
right,
on.
Right, and that's where we're at right now as they line up for the PK. What were your thoughts here, Coach, as they pull up within one?
Yeah, I mean, you kind of can't believe it's happened because we've controlled the game. They had only been at our end of the field maybe a couple of times, and they draw the foul and get the PK, and you just think, oh, soccer can be a cruel game that way. But
right.
But
this was their last real crack at it to try to equalize.
Yeah, they had two balls crossed into the box right at the end. One went right by a guy, and then they got the head on that one. So you're kind of holding your breath at the end. But our guys had been resilient all year, had really battled back. Honestly, in my mind, worst case scenario, we go to overtime, and I felt really confident that we could kind of take that thing if we needed to.
So all I had heard all throughout while I was in Murfreesboro and covering you guys was CAK.
Right.
Was how good CAK was. If it's a team that's going to challenge CPA, they said it's CAK or CPA.
Yeah.
That's one of the two teams that are going to win. So what were your thoughts heading into that CAK game, knowing how tough of a match it was going to be?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, on some level, we wanted to play the very best team in the state tournament, and we knew from the get-go that was CAK. Signal Mountain had had a great year. Hume Fog had had a great year. But CAK had won, what, 8 out of 11, so they've been there. It was our fourth time to match up with them. Every goal, every game, 0-0, 1-0, 1-0. So we knew that it was two programs, two schools that are very similar, two programs that really have produced a lot of quality teams over the year. We knew they would play great soccer. We knew it would be a physical, tough game.
Yeah,
and so really, it's what we wanted. I mean, we wanted to play that kind of game to finish. So I don't think the guys were intimidated, but they knew it was going to take their best effort to get through it.
Did you think that your guys... I know that they haven't been there since 99, but did you think that they might have felt the pressure of, you know, this is our first chance to win it for our school, for the purple, for the CPA, for that, you know, the name that's on the front of their jersey? Did you think they felt any of that pressure to get that result?
You know, remarkably, before the game warming up, they were so loose, I was almost worried with how loose. Oh, gosh. They're joking around. They're laughing.
I noticed that about your team all year, that they did seem very loose. None of the guys seemed to be really tense. I mean, they were so talented that it's not that they didn't care. But it was just like they were, like you said, very loose, very relaxed. They were joking around. They seemed like a fun bunch of guys to be around.
Absolutely. And it was that team chemistry that carried us. But I think they knew that all we can do is play our best. And if we're against a team that's better than we are, maybe we get lucky. But, you know, all we can do is all we can do. And so even before this game, they were determined to have a blast out there playing soccer. And that's fun as a coach. Now, after the game, I look out there on the field and they got their hands on their heads like they can't believe they've just done it.
Right.
So I think the weight of what they had accomplished kind of came down on them as those final seconds are ticking off.
Yeah.
But prior to that time, I thought they played loose, and I thought they played together, and I thought they played CPA soccer. So, that was really
special. Let's break down this play. This is y'all have a free kick. Harrison Myers is going to take it, and he is going to play as close to a perfect ball as you possibly can into the box here.
Yes.
To get you guys the what ended up being the game-winning goal.
Right. We had a number of free kicks prior to that, and Harrison had kind of bent them in around the six, and their keeper had come out and snagged every one.
Uh-huh.
So I think that one he was determined to drive it more on a line toward that back post. He kept it out. It was probably 8 or 10 yards from goal. Josh Pettuccini, right, 6'3", really good in the air, got up.
It's nice having a guy at 6'3" who can get up and put that ball in.
And Josh had just subbed into the game a few minutes before that, had an up-and-down year, but, I mean, he couldn't have played that any better. And got on it, headed it down right in the corner. Their keeper made a great effort, just snuck in there.
And so you talk about your guys being loose. That's a group of guys who cared. You saw Walker coming out. They're all hugging, knowing that goal came late, and knowing that, okay, we got the lead. This could be it. We're about ready to win the state championship. We just got to keep them out of the goal, and we got this.
Right. And up to that point, CAK really hadn't created many scoring chances, so I think our guys believe. Now, they pushed, and they got a couple at the end.
They got a couple of chances towards the end, but nothing really serious. Right.
A couple of headers that made my heart jump in my throat. Here's a funny Walker story, right? At the very end, guy comes in, Walker comes sliding out, collision. Walker's there screaming at the top of his lungs, can't feel his leg. And so I go run out on the field. He's like, my leg. As I get to him, he rolls over and he's like, Coach, I saved the shot. I saved it, Coach. And I was like, yep, Walker, we're going to win state. There's 40 seconds left and you did it.
Oh, there's 40 seconds left. Talk about how neat that was, that substitution.
Yeah.
I mean, not neat that Walker got hurt, obviously, but for the replacement and who that was.
Yeah, that's my son, Jacob. Walker was playing TSC on a club team all spring. And so we made a deal with our guys, we had three of them, that if they would come to practice when they could, that when they became eligible to play, they could be part of the team. And so Walker did that, came back early April. So up to that time, Jacob had been our goalkeeper and did a fantastic job. Had six or seven shutouts and played really well. But Walker's a really good keeper. And so Jacob kind of stepped aside. And so for him to be able to step out on the field for that last 40 seconds.
So now you're not just a coach, you're a dad. 40 seconds, and I mean, how nerve-wracking was that? Thinking if a ball goes in.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
How was, what was going through your head there?
Yeah, well, that's my first thought is like, oh no, if they score, Jacob's going to feel like he left off. But as soon as I thought about it, it's like, they're not going to score. And Jacob came out there with that confident look on his face, like, yeah. We got this.
Yeah.
And our backs, you know, were solid. And so I don't think I don't think he had to touch the ball. I think we won it out of the back a couple times. Although they had throws down there, but I knew he'd take care of it.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
So as you're listening to the fans count down those final 5 seconds.
Right.
What is that like? Those final 5 seconds as head coach of CPA, knowing that this is a state title. What was described?
Unbelievable.
That
I mean, they played a ball down the middle. I can remember it pretty clearly. Jake Brown steps up and wins the ball, and I'm watching the clock. It's like 6-5, and then Jake just clears it. So at that point, you know it's done.
Yeah.
And watching that ball sail over my head and. They're still counting down. The boys are starting to run out on the field. It's kind of indescribable what washes over you at that moment. I mean, part of me is kind of in tears, and part of me just can't believe it happened, and part of me is surreal, but really happy for those guys. They wanted it so badly. And I think there's a part of them where they wanted to send me out that way.
Oh, definitely. You could tell. You could tell as soon as the players hoisted you up and they were saying, thank you, coach. They were chanting, thank you, coach. And that was such just being there and seeing that and seeing how much the players respected you was really cool.
Yeah, that's a humbling thing. That's a humbling thing. So, couldn't have been better.
Describe that a little bit more. For people who didn't get to see that moment, it was kind of your final time with the players as their coach, and them kind of sending you out the right way and then thanking you.
Well, that whistle blows, and they're all running like banshees all over the field, right? Ripping shirts off, jumping around.
Yeah.
And then kind of one by one, they're running back to me. Hugs, tears in both of our eyes. And then we get together, and they hand me my coach's trophy, and then they hand the guys the state championship trophy, and they're dancing around with it. And I'm kind of in the back of the pack, and then big old Paul Adams, right, our 6'7", 275-pound guy, grabs me and just throws me up in the air. So I'm sitting there looking. And then they start chanting, and there's a lot of love among the guys and on that team, and they kind of all came flowing out there at the end. So
I assume just from talking to you after the game, and you said those last 15 minutes, you said you were trying to hold back tears just because it was just like, wow, it's really, you know, it's almost over, and how much are you going to miss this?
Yeah, when Josh scored, you know, you'd think I'd be jumping around, but the reaction was those emotions just over. And I started crying on the sideline. I'm like, okay. One of my assistant coaches is like, Brett, you can't cry through the end of this game. And I'm like, okay, I'll get myself together.
Right.
And then we're looking at the clock, like every 15 seconds, wishing it would tick down. But it's indescribable. You work so hard. And it's not all about the winning. But there is something that really validates all that work and all that effort. And seeing what it meant to those guys and them knowing how much it meant to me. Perfect way to
That is really
wrap
too cool.
Up. Yeah, yeah.
It was State champion 2014. Is that a nice ring to it?
It's got a great ring
the
to
first,
it. Yeah.
How about this? The first year of head coach, he's the state champion. And his last year as head coach, he's a state champion. That is unbelievable. I can't think of how too many times that has happened.
No.
That is really awesome. Thanks, coach, for coming
thank
out.
You. Thank really you. All right.
All right, so CPA and Franklin, we've talked to them. Now we have a third Williamson County team that won state this year. They're right down the road from us, and that's Battleground Academy. We'll have their head coach and a couple players come on and talk about that when we return here on Sports Source, brought to you by Franklin Motor Company. Stay tuned. Thank you.